Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to Ahkam SOS, the show that discusses Islamic duties and practices. MashaAllah, we have gone past the halfway mark of Ramadan. Inshallah, most of you guys will be you'll be observing your 16th, 17th fast, inshallah, and preparing for the istishhad of Imam Ali alayhi salam, and also for Laylatul Qadr. Inshallah, tonight's discussion, we'll be discussing more on Laylatul Qadr, the importance of this night, the amal of this night, and a little bit more on that. Quick reminder to all our viewers that this is a live show and we do take in your questions. If you have any questions you'd like to ask us, please send them via the WhatsApp or the email address, or alternatively you can call us, the number's right there, call us and we'll be more than happy to answer your questions, inshallah. I'm your host Mohsin Shah. Joining me is Sheikh Alima. Assalamu alaikum Sheikhna.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Sheikhna, how are you this evening before I begin, and how's your fast going?
Alhamdulillah, all going fine, alhamdulillah.
MashaAllah. Sheikhna, what are the amal of Laylatul Qadr? I mean, a lot of us are, you know, we come to Laylatul Qadr, we know it's an important night, we're not sure what the amal are. I'm sure there's plenty of amal, but let me ask you, what is the most important amal, and what do you recommend to do on this night?
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على محمد وآله الطيبين الطاهرين ولعنة الله على أعدائهم أجمعين. Let me mention a hadith or a short discussion between رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله and Imam أمير المؤمنين علي عليه السلام. With this regard, Imam Ali asks Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi about the most important or the best deed of this month to be performed. So he says, فَقُلْتُ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ مَا أَفْضَلُ الْأَعْمَالِ فِي هَذَا الشَّهْرِ. What is the best deed in this holy month? In overall, not only on Laylatul Qadr. In overall, what is the best deed that we can perform in this holy month that pleases Allah Azza wa Jal, that brings to us, you know, the in terms of the self-building and being able to reach the levels of perfection. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, he says, يَا أَبَا الْحَسَنْ أَفْضَلُ الْأَعْمَالِ فِي هَذَا الشَّهْرِ الْوَرَعْ عَنْ مَحَارِمِ اللَّهِ. O Abu al-Hasan, O Ali alayhi salam, the best deed or the most important deed in this holy month is to abstain and refrain from maharim Allah, what Allah has made forbidden and haram. You see, sometimes we have, they mention taqwa, piety. You have taqwa, which means to do the wajib and to refrain from the haram. And we have the wara. Wara is the upper level, is the higher level in which the concentration and the emphasis is made on abstaining and refraining the haram, what Allah made haram, what Allah made forbidden. We try our best in this holy month, the remaining 14 days, less or more, to abstain from every haram that we know. If we don't know, we have to ask, is this haram? Can I do this? Can I do that? For example, you know, some people might not be able to recognize what the harams are, the things which are forbidden. You know, sometimes we do some trades or for example, buying and selling, and we don't know what haram is within this transaction. Is it a halal transaction, for example? Sometimes we sit down in our gatherings. We have sisters with us. We have non-mahram with us. Am I allowed to chat and crack jokes and laugh and make the opposite gender laugh with me as well and crack jokes? Is that halal in such gatherings? Be it at work, be it at a community center, in the let's say at home when they come and visit us. Can I, even if she's a cousin or something, a close relative, it doesn't matter. Can I actually do this? Is this halal? Can I shake my hand with the opposite gender at work, for example, or in the hospital or appointments and so forth? I need to find what the haram is so I can prevent it. Without knowledge, I will be diving into the acts of sin and haram. And that's why we have to gain knowledge in this field, and the knowledge of knowing the basics, harams. What are harams and what are the wajib? So I won't basically be committing these acts in which we'll be asked, na'udhu billah. And if I don't get the repentance and tawbah, of course, I'll have to basically pay back. La samahallah. Then the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he cries, thumma baka, the hadith says, he cried after saying this. So the Imam Ali alayhi salam, he asks, فَقُلْتُ يَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ مَا يُبْكِيكَ, what makes you to cry, O Rasulullah? He said, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi, فَقَالَ يَا عَلِي أَبْكِي لِمَا يُسْتَحَلُّ مِنْكَ فِي هَذَا الشَّهْرِ, I cry to what's going to happen to you in this holy month. يُسْتَحَلُّ means they make it permissible, halal to shed your bread, your blood, sorry. It becomes halal for them. It becomes permissible for them to shed the blood of the second best person Allah created as the best creation of Allah Azza wa Jal. ثاني أفضل خلق الله بعد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله. The second best of the creations. So the Holy Prophet صلى الله عليه وآله, he tells him that they will shed your blood in this holy month, O Ya Ali. Imam alayhi salam, he says to him, فَقُلْتُ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ وَذَلِكَ فِي سَلَامَةٍ مِنْ دِينِي, is this going to be in the safety of my religion, my faith? It's going to basically be in the safe side. يعني, in other words, I sacrifice myself, but my religion will stay safe, will continue in the right path. The Holy Prophet responds and he says, فِي سَلَامَةٍ مِنْ دِينِكَ, yes, your religion will be in safe side. Your deen, Islam, will be on safe side, inshallah, won't be deviated like other religions, which deviated from the right path. So, of course, we are coming into this holy night, the 19th night of the month of Ramadan, in which it's Laylatul Qadr, and the Shahada of Imam Ali alayhi salam. So we try to commemorate and also to invoke Allah Azza wa Jal in this holy month and in this night particularly. The a'mal of this night, the 19th night of the Qadr, Laylatul Qadr al-Ula, as they mentioned, initially there is a ghusl, if the one can do the ghusl in the Maghrib time, in the Ghurub time, the one can do the ghusl, prepare himself for starting the ad'iyah and the ziyarat and so forth. So the ghusl is recommended. Number two, Ziyarat al-Mawla Abi Abdullah al-Husayn alayhi salam, to visit the Mawla in Karbala. This is, I think, a special ziyarah for the night of the Qadr. Although we can't go there now due to the pandemic issue and the airports are closed, we visit the Imam alayhi salam from the far distance. So we try to visit the Imam alayhi salam in this holy night as well. To recite dua al-Jawshan al-Kabir, again, very important dua, a long dua.
MashaAllah, yeah, very long, mashaAllah.
Mentioning the Asma'ullah Azza wa Jal.
A thousand names of Allah.
Allah Azza wa Jal, yes. We invoke Allah with His names in this dua. Also, another mustahab or recommended act is to put the Quran on the head, over the head, place the Quran on the head, and invoke Allah, bika ya Allah, and to besiege Muhammad al Muhammad salamullah alayhim, ya bi Muhammadin bi Aliin bi Fatima, till the Imam al Hujjah ajal farajahu al Sharif. We besiege them and invoke Allah Azza wa Jal in this holy night. The other amal is to say istighfar 100 times, astaghfirullah Rabbi wa atubu ilayh, 100 times to ask Allah Azza wa Jal's forgiveness in this particular night. And of course, to say la'na on the killers of Imam Ali alayhi salam 100 times. Allahumma al'an qatalata amir al-mu'minin 100 times. You say it 100 times in this holy night. There is also two rak'ah salah you would perform. So two rak'ah salah, like salat al-subuh, with the intention of this night of the Laylatul Qadr. You recite alhamd once, of course, alhamd. and then seven times Surah Tawheed, قل هو الله أحد, seven times each rak'ah. When you finish and do that salam, you say أستغفر الله وأتوب إليه. You mentioned the استغفار after the salah. Let me also mention hadith with this regard about the greatness of this holy night, Laylatul Qadr. In a narration from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alih, he says that in this night, تفتح أبواب السماوات في ليلة القدر. The doors of the heavens would be opened in this night of Qadr. A specific and feature and in this holy night in which doors are open, خلاص, whatever you need, whatever you're requesting, the sins, whatever we have, we try to invoke Allah Azza wa Jal because the dua will be taken up, you know, quickly, and the doors are open. The mercy, forgiveness, rahmah, maghfirah, seeking hajat, needs, and so forth. Then he says, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, فَمَا مِنْ عَبْدٍ يُصَلِّي فِيهَا إِلَّا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى لَهُ بِكُلِّ سَجْدَةٍ شَجَرَةً فِي الْجَنَّةِ. The one who prays in this holy night, and he just, this is just one of the thawab, one sajda only that he makes in this salah, let's say a turaka salah, as I mentioned, hamdu sab'a qul huwallah, sab'a qul huwallah, if he just do one sajda in this turaka salah, which he has, of course, every turaka salah of mustahab, he's got four sajda. One sajda that you do in this holy night, Allah would give you a tree in paradise. Mashallah. And Allah knows what is inside this tree. It's not like the tree of the dunya. Just a few apples or a few oranges and that's it. No, it's a great, great blessing of Allah Azza wa Jal. When he gives, Allah is Kareem, Allah is Jawad, Allah is generous when he gives a tree to a mu'min. So you would get four trees for every salah you pray, two rak'ah. Imagine. And then he says, وبكل ركعة بيتا في الجنة. And with every rak'ah you recite and perform, you get a house in paradise. So you have actually two rak'ah in each salah mustahab. So that's two houses you get in paradise. And Allah knows what is inside this house. Imagine the house that Allah gives you. It's not like the house of this dunya. Filled with rooms and it's like a, well, I can't even say like a palace or a mansion. Mm-hmm. We cannot imagine how great are these houses that Allah would give to the mu'min in the hereafter. Also, he says, وَبِكُلِّ تَشَهُدٍ, with every tashahud that you sit down before you end the salah, أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا وَحْدَهُ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ. When you say tashahud before you end the salah, غُرْفَةً مِنْ غُرْفَاتِ الْجَنَّةِ. Allah will also give you a room in one of the rooms of the paradise. It seems to me that the bayt and ghurfa are different. The bayt is ground floor and the ghurfa is upper floor.
Upstairs, I see.
Let's say in a building. So you'll have a bedroom or a flat in a building where you can see the paradise from up there. So a great bounty and na'im in Jannah. وَبِكُلِّ تَسْلِيمَةٍ حُلَّةٌ مِنْ حُلَلِ الْجَنَّةِ. With every taslim, when you say assalamu alayka ayyuhan nabi, assalamu alayna, you get a garment or a suit from the garments and the suits of the paradise. Imagine if Allah gives you a suit or a garment. Allah knows what beauty has and the jamal has in this garment. Of course, the hadith is long, and detailed. There are lots of thawab and rewards are given. Also, the hadith says when the fajr time comes, Allah would give such and such of bounties and thawab and gifts and so forth. I'm not going to go through in details. I would stop up to here, inshallah. We'd go for the next question. Or if you have anything.
Ahsan, thank you so much, Sheikhna. MashaAllah, plenty of amal. Sheikhna, sometimes, you know, when it comes to dua, we don't even know what to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, we're always encouraged to pray for your brothers and sisters in the Ummah, pray for the Imam of our time. I don't know what to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So please, Sheikh, enlighten me. What is the best du'a to ask during Laylatul Qadr?
Well, the first dua the one can ask is to read and recite dua, as you mentioned, for the Imam al-Zaman, ajjala farajahu al-Sharif, for his reappearance, for his well-being. We try to give sadaqah on his behalf, the sadaqah on his behalf on this night. And we ask Allah Azza wa Jal to ease this situation of this, on this ummah, on this nation, this pandemic issue to be, taken away from this world, and all those who are in difficulty to be able to regain their health and go back to their normal life, inshallah. And may Allah bless the marhumin, those who passed away due to this pandemic. And may Allah bless them and gather them with Muhammad Ali Muhammad and with the Salihin in the hereafter. Also, the one can recite important dua. I try to recite it every year if I don't forget, of course. And Laylatul Qadr is Dua al-Afiyah. Dua al-Afiyah. You'll find it in Sahifa al-Sajjadiyah by al-Imam al-Sajjad Zain al-Abidin alayhi salam. Very important dua. Dua al-Afiyah. It's all, most of the dua, when you read it, it says Afiyah, 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 wa as'aluka al-Afiyah, and so forth. The name of Afiyah, which means well-being. Well-being, yes. in bodily, well-being in the soul, in the mind, in the akhirah, dunya and akhirah. We need this well-being in all aspects, not only just for my bodily aspects, material aspects. No, we need the well-being in all aspects, the akhirah as well. Afiyat al-dunya wal akhirah. You'll, inshallah, find and recite the du'an and you see these words. Afiyat al-dunya wal akhirah. We need the afiyat dunya akhirah in everything and every aspect. We need the afiyah. When I have knowledge as a alim, I have to have the afiyah in order to be able to deliver the right and true message and not to na'udhu billah deviate others with the wrong thoughts, with the deviant thoughts and wrong aqidah, for example. To have this afiyah as well in deen and dunya and akhirah, in everything, in knowledge. So dua al-afiyah, very important. Also an important dua to recite that, oh Allah, make our endings a peaceful ending, a happy ending, on the right path, the ending of the right path. Similar to the Hur al-Riyahi, Ridwanullah alayhi, who ended his life in felicity, in happiness with Abi Abdullah al-Husayn alayhi salam. That he didn't join the army of Ibn Ziyad or Ibn Sa'd la'anhumullah. He joined Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam. He left them. So we have to have this dua and ask that Allah Azza wa Jal, Allahumma ij'al awaqib umurina khayra. Make our awaqib, the endings are khayr. Last ending, we don't want to be, na'udhu billah, deviated on the last, yes, hours or days or years of our life. Zubayr ibn Awam, a very famous companion of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, and as well, he was companion of Ali alayhi salam, and he defended Amir al-Mu'min alayhi salam and the door of Fatima alayhi salam. He went there, he was there, he took out his sword and protected this house, but unfortunately his aqibah, his ending was very bad, that he came out in the battle of Camel to fight Ali ibn Abi Talib, although he left the battlefield and he walked out of the battlefield, but the aqibah was bad. So we ask Allah Azza wa Jalla in this night to make our awaqib, our endings, a good endings. Aqibat umur khair. That's what we want. Otherwise, I can be 60, 70 years a pious person, a mu'min, a lecturer, an alim, a scholar, guide people, or even a normal person, a merchant, a specific field, for example, a doctor, whatever. And I serve the community, I serve people, I serve my religion, but at the end of the day, na'udhu billah, things will change, na'udhu billah, samahallah. And I become deviant, na'udhu billah. So we ask Allah in this holy night to make our endings a good endings and peaceful endings, and with barakat Muhammad wa ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Inshallah, inshallah. Sheikh, when we look at the surah Qadr, and if I'm allowed to, I'll skip a couple of verses. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Laylatul Qadr khayrun min alf shahr, which means that the night of Qadr is greater than 1,000 months. Which is takriban, if you calculate it, that's like 83 years. Tanazzalul malaikatu ruhu fiha bi'izni rabbihim min kulli amr salawna hayat tabtal fajr. As in, the angels and the spirits descend with the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and there is peace until dawn until the Fajr, until it rises. So there's so much in the Quran, there's so much significance on this night. On this night, you know, the Quran was also, you know, brought down to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wa alihi in entirety. When we do our amal, one can argue that the amal can be like, if you do one prayer, it is as if you've done prayer for 1,000 months on that one night. And whatever deeds you do will be multiplied by, like, you know, by like 1,000 months, arguably speaking. So what is the best deed to do on the night of Qadr?
According to the ulama, even the past ulama, I found a statement from Alim who died about 200 years ago, with the surname of Amili, Al-Amili, mm-hmm. Sayyid Al-Amili. He mentions that the consensus of the ulama in his time, and even now, many of our ulama would also mention this fact, that one of the best deeds in this holy night, the Nayl Qadr, is to seek knowledge, talabul ilm.
Oh, wow.
Many ulama will sit in this holy night. Of course, after you have done your amal, make sure you do not neglect the amal of Laylatul Qadr. Make sure that you have enough time to do the salah, the ziyarah, the ghusl. If you can recite the Jawshan Kabir, place the Quran on your head, the amal of the Quran, and so forth. You had an hour, let's say, spare time. Try to open a book of hadith, of tafsir of Quran. Try to see what Ali Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam have said and mentioned in the hadith, in the statements, in the tafsir of the holy verses. So the ulama in over would encourage that if one can actually be able to seek knowledge in this holy night. Of course, we don't forget the hadith of the Imam alayhi salam with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that the best amal in this holy month is to refrain from the haram. But as a amal as well, along with the amal of dua and ziyara, is also the one, very importantly, to be able to seek knowledge. And that's also desirable if the one can actually be able to seek knowledge, is one of the good amal as well.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Sheikhna, for your time and for all your effort. Thank you to all of you for joining us. Inshallah, you will remember us in your du'as on Laylatul Qadr. One thing I would like to say is that if you have any Qadr prayers, please, these are wajib. These take priority over all of the amal. Make sure if you have a Qadr prayers, you use Laylatul Qadr to pay back those prayers that you owe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inshallah. I believe, Sheikhna, we're having a short break and we'll be back on the afternoon after Laylatul Qadr. So there won't be any episodes until after Laylatul Qadr, inshallah. On the 23rd day, 24th night, we will be having the next Ahkam SOS program. Until then, please remember us in your du'as. Inshallah, we look forward to seeing you on that day. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah wa barakatuh.